That's alright now, mama, any way you do.
I like when anybody just runs out of lyrics. Dee dee dee.
Well, babies, us the king on the Bennington show.
Hello, and welcome to Scope Talk Live. I'm your host, Chris Stanley, with my panel, Ron and Gail Bennington. Thanks, guys. Scope Talk Live, STL.
Chris, we're actually doing our show.
But see, you guys, you were a little bit late this morning, so we weren't able to do Scope Talk.
We're a little bit late today, if you're going to be totally honest.
We weren't able to do our normal slot for Scope Talk Live, so I thought we'd do it now.
You know what this is?
What's that?
It's Perk Talk Live. Chris Stanley has taken the Percocets. I mean, this is... It's number one sign of addiction because when you're taking medicine, you're not supposed to be thrilled about it.
That's great.
Only addictive.
This is so good. I'm so glad I had this surgery.
They give them to me, and it's okay,
dude. I was watching you coming in in the cab today when you were doing your what do you call your show, Smoking with Chris?
Smoking with Chris, 10:45 a.m. every Friday morning.
No, I'm wearing a heavy coat because it's chilly in New York City. And you were sweating like you were standing in front of a furnace.
I'm sweating like that right now because, well, I ate the Periscopes. I ate the Percocets.
Oh, God.
I ate the Percocets, and they make me sweaty. They dehydrate me. I opened Smoking with Chris today, eating Percocets.
Yes, we're all aware of that.
It's very cool.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
They're prescribed to me.
Hey, everybody, guys, I've got these drugs here. Yeah.
Everybody in 11th grade thinks that you're a real rebel. all right, so we will open the show with a little, what is it called again?
Scope Talk Live, STL.
Scope Talk Live is Chris's eight shows that he does on Periscope.
Yeah, Smoke with Chris, 420 Blaze It, and then there's also, you know, Mets, I like to keep the Mets people happy.
And then there was just like Uber rides.
Yeah, I'm thinking about doing a new one where Get to Know Your Uber Driver, where I interview Uber drivers.
And then there's even a new one called Tom Sharpling Beat the Shit Out of Chris.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yes.
Guess what? Tom Sharpling could eat my ass because I beat the shit out of him. Because if you were watching Scope Talk on Wednesday night, guess what? Someone came up to me in the street, called me the Roman Polanski of Periscope.
They could have just called you the Roman Polanski of New York City.
Because Tom Sharpling of The Best Show tried to talk shit about my camera skills.
Because what? While you were talking, I saw it drop down. I saw a close-up of your chest for 9 seconds.
I got a bad arm.
Here's the thing. Chris, Tom Sharpling invites me on his show, The Best Show. Classy show.
Yeah.
I like the way you've started. Look what you've done.
He started it.
I love the opening to that show, too.
Isn't it great?
Yeah. Makes Joe look like an asshole.
Fuck.
All right, wait. You can show Joe through his monitor.
Oh, yeah.
Kevin Plansky of Touching Kids.
No, of film. Film.
Oh, wait. Why are you dancing cool and putting up a cap? All right, well, Scope Talk Live, which Gail and I somehow get to be on Chris's panel.
Love it. Thanks, guys, for being on the panel.
This is about Periscopes that we've seen.
It's usually a bi-weekly show, Mondays and Fridays, I feel.
Well, because normally we're excited to be in here. By the way, people were saying, hey, how come you didn't do Opie Radio? It was actually Denny was bothering me about it while I was taking a piss. And as always, for no apparent reason, I blame it on the Stangle brothers.
Right? Oh, yeah.
I go, the Stangles are keeping us off there. And I'm very proud, and I want us to copyright this, Chris.
Done.
Well, you haven't even heard me say it
yet. You know.
I said that they've got a stanglehold.
Get it. Copyright.
Now, you're stangling the life out of it.
You've got to go out and do a parody song of Stranglehold with Stanglehold.
Baby.
That's just the beginning of it. I mean, I love what you're doing with it, but I don't know whether Joe... Why aren't we getting a close-up on Joe now, too?
Oh.
Roman Polanski.
Yeah. I'm glad that it'll be in his signature falsetto, though.
Yeah.
Why are you...
Yeah, exactly. Everything is Prince, 1979 Prince, before when he was still the underground guy. By the way, why weren't you offended when someone called you the Roman Polanski of anything?
Chinatown. All right, he directed Chinatown. All right, that's a compliment.
And then 2 years later, he drugged a 13-year-old girl and had anal sex with her and ran out of the country. And today, it was in the news today that they're trying to get him back in the country and can't do it.
Guess what? Yeah, you can't get him, America. You can't get him. He's out there.
This guy should have just went and did his time.
Like that's a gentleman. All.
Yes.
Like a gentleman does.
Yeah, like a good dude.
Look, I could separate the personal life from the art. And I don't think that's a problem. I think his work speaks for itself.
What was that camera angle?
I don't know.
Sharpling is so correct about everything.
No, Sharpling is correct about nothing.
This is something new now. Chris, I know that you go to Russia, right?
Oh, yeah, all the time.
So this is my new bit because apparently this thing that we did when we were in third grade isn't known around the world. So when you're in China, Japan, Russia, a lot of those people will just read whatever you put up. Normally, I'll just put up New York City and they'll go like this. They're doing all like Russian talk and then do New York City. But then I'll just put in Mike Hunt. As if it was third grade. And they all fall for it. So I even did it to two girls from L.A. last night as well. Until they finally caught on to when I did Mike Hunt is soaked. That's when they started laughing and said, good joke.
They're the best.
You got me.
Yeah, so let's try.
For them, though.
Let's try to scope that back out there. What have you periscoped on this week?
Well, this week I saw a great periscope of Jenny Hutt.
You watch a lot of Hutt.
Yeah, I do. Right. Honestly, she got me into Periscope. I'm not going to lie.
Yeah.
She was really the first person I followed on Periscope.
Well, she was on it when it was just called Para. They hadn't even finished the name by the time she went on.
But she broke the Jared Fogle story for me. Jared Fogle story. And I'm like, I'm actually getting news on Periscope now.
I saw that one because the title that she put up was, guys, aren't you so grossed out by Jared Fogle and the girl who videotaped him? And she's doing all this and she's late for her radio show.
Yeah.
Because she's periscoping what should be the topic of her show.
But she also addressed that I am always welcome as a guest on her show.
On her Periscope show or a radio show?
I don't think she sees the difference, really. Much like us, no.
Yeah, much like her life is the same. What else did I... well, you know who's got me a little bit, too. Because I saw it this morning. I guess it was done in the middle of the night. Danny Golightly did I Love Anthony. And I thought, oh, my God, here it is. She's trying to get in. But she was showing an Anthony Jeselnik set. And I'm like, great title. Clickbait that shit.
Got him.
Clickbait
it. Yeah.
She knows how to reel them in.
Yeah.
She's always got, like, hashtag sexy teens or
something.
Yeah,
those are the ones I won't click on.
Really?
I
jump in.
Yeah, I know you do. I know you do.
I saw some girls in Alabama having twerk contests. And they were just twerking it. They were just twerking it. It was great.
Well, I saw one in L.A. that was definite less than zero. What's the writer's name who...
Bret Easton Ellis.
Yeah. This was Bret Easton Ellis's stuff where a girl was rubbing herself. And,
hell yeah.
Like, you know how like people will ask people to do stuff and they don't, of course?
Yeah.
These girls were like, great idea. We're getting in the shower. And it was three kind of chubby, trashy L.A. girls.
Yeah.
And their gay friend. And I'm like, this is Bret Easton Ellis.
It's perfect. Just depravity.
Yeah.
I like that. That's still going on.
And they're like, I like being on E and doing heroin. Great.
Wow. You sound great.
And they're just beat looking and they're like 21. You know?
Used up.
Yeah, just.
So haggard.
Yeah, just finished at age 21. But their parents are rich and they're in LA with some kind of odd dream, you know?
It's a glamorous life, really.
Yeah, they're all excited because they went to a party that, you know, was thrown by the grandfathered TV show. Whatever it happened to be, it seemed like it was glamorous to them, but to us, the viewer, sad. Sad.
Well, there was a big smoking with Chris this morning as well.
The smoking with Chris, Taking the buttered roll for breakfast was a shocker for me.
What's wrong with that? A buttered roll is a great breakfast. And a Red Bull.
It's a Jersey breakfast.
That's a bizarre breakfast.
Yeah. The only place that's well known, hard roll and butter, is Jersey for breakfast. That I call a Jersey donut.
That feels to me like a breakfast, like, oh, I forgot my wallet, but I do have this quarter in my back pocket.
Hey, yeah. I also tipped the guy like $3 on that buttered roll and Red Bull. And you missed that. All right, look, I had a guest cancel on me. It was Liam from the booking department.
Oh, you know why?
Why is that?
He's been Stanglehold.
Oh, God damn it.
Is that it? That's all you have so far?
I got the sweet guitar lick.
Yeah, let's hear it. That's such like a 70s cop theme, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's the greatest thing Ted Nugent ever did, and he's well aware of it, too.
He knows it. Oh, he knows.
Well, no, then also he killed a small deer with a bow. So that was pretty cool.
Manly.
I got the best for Scope Talk Live. This is my new favorite person out there.
Okay.
Young, crazy kid, making things happen. Calls himself Intern Alex.
Oh, what the
fuck? And he's street. He's got Scope Bros.
Yeah.
He gets his shares from his Scope Bros.
I have the Scope Bros. I started Scope Bros.
Yeah, but people are actually calling him the Roman Polanski of Periscope. I heard someone.
That's mine. I'm the Roman Polanski of Periscope. Scope Bros is mine. If you want to be a Scope Bro, hit that share button. That's mine. I invented it. Intern Alex, you're in a world of shit. Rip me off.
You got it from him.
No. He got it from me. Oh. All right?
Doesn't matter who did it first. It's who does it better, and he's young, and he's fresh, and he's sitting in the middle of Chatta Boogie, a party town.
He doesn't know what he's doing!
He's got a lot of great co-workers. I mean, he had a lot of great guests on his Periscope.
I had the Statue of Liberty on my show on Smoke and Chris just this morning. The fucking Statue of Liberty.
It wasn't the real one. That Mexican guy who dresses up that way. Who sometimes I see eating lunch.
Oil can!
Yeah, I know.
How can he speak? Well, terrified me.
It's, I guess he just doesn't want to give away the illusion, you know?
Yeah, sure.
That he is the Statue of Liberty.
It was a huge booking. I'd like to see Alex, the intern or whatever. Intern Alex, get that in Chattanooga. Huh? No. He's ripping me off.
What's his radio station?
It's, I believe it's Hits 96.
Here's the other thing. Why is he still an intern after 7 years?
I don't get it.
That's his thing. You know what I mean? He's Intern Alex. He must have really...
I put him in an afternoon drive, counting down the hits.
I'll tell you what, though. When he took those stairs and he was running down the stairs and screaming.
I could do that.
It was so funny.
I could do that.
I could do that better than him.
You should go down all 36 floors here.
Like, it reminded me of when you were running in the rain and smoking, but it's, like, funnier. Like, right. A funnier
Give me version. Come on! I did it first!
Look, you're the Roman Polanski of Subway.
No.
We all get that.
Polanski of Periscope.
Look, see how bad you're directing this.
I'm very sweaty. It's pouring off me. Check it out.
Are you eating like... Yeah, get a close-up of you.
I can feel it dripping into my eyes.
I don't know whether you're eating perks or just like hot fucking barbecue tacos. Why are they heating you up like this?
They dehydrate you, so it's forcing me to sweat more than I usually sweat.
Does the Red Bull help with the dehydration?
I feel like it makes it faster. It makes, you know, it makes me feel faster, you know?
Makes me feel faster.
Oh, but yeah, Intern Alex, shit list.
He just moaned.
Sharply, shit list. Scope Bros, share it. Mine.
What? I don't know, dude.
Give me some hearts, too. Scope Talk Live, STL.
Oh, yeah, we are on his show, STL.
Thanks, panel. Thank you guys for showing up today. I really appreciate it, seriously.
No one ever calls their panel individual.
Thanks, panel.
You guys are Scope Bros, for real.
I feel like we're the OG Scope Bros.
Oh,
I don't think we had enough chance to jump into the opening of our show. I mean, we opened with the King, and then all of a sudden I start hearing screaming about Scope Talk.
I know. We had a really great rockabilly.
I know. It was the
Bobby
end of...
Jackson and Buddy Holly.
Yeah. And then the Roman Polanski of the Stangleholds jumps on top of us and takes over the show.
Look, this is this goddamn Periscope Network. STL's a big show.
Oh, by the way, Denny also gave me a two-sheet for Halloween songs.
What?
Oh, great.
Yeah. Denny hasn't been back on the show since I forgot I yelled at him one day, and I thought in a jokey manner, but his feelings were really hurt.
But it seems like you guys are mending it now. I mean,
well, we just pissed. We're on the same piss fucking schedule. You know? Yeah.
Does he have a Periscope show?
Everybody has one. I mean, I saw this thing that they've got out. It's a piece of furniture, a desk, I guess, that you can stay on the internet with it 24 hours a day. That you can, you know, it'll always be on Periscope or whatever.
Yes.
And I'm not even making this up. Guess what they're naming it? It's called the Jenny Hutch. And it's just this little, I guess she's going to be talking about it.
She's obviously the spokeswoman.
Yeah. And then every once in a while her husband walks by and goes, are you still on that? Come back.
You need to support her.
He doesn't support her very much. He doesn't care.
He's hating.
Scope dream, and she's chasing it every day.
And she's chasing something. I don't know what it is.
Chasing that dragon.
Chasing depression.
She's not chasing the dragon.
You're chasing the dragon, sweaty.
It's just so hot in here.
You're the that's what it is.
It isn't for real.
I'm still wearing my jacket.
I'm soaked in sweat.
Yes, because you're eating perks one after another.
Yeah, I am.
When are you off the meds?
In 4 weeks. Or 3 weeks. 3 weeks.
Yeah. 3 weeks officially, 4 weeks actually, in your world.
At least that's, you know, that's what they say. That's when the arm comes out of the sling. That's what they told me.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean that you're in perks the entire time.
And that arm is not going to come out of the sling in 3 weeks if you're using it as much as I see you using it.
It's going to come out. I'm going to physical therapy. It's going to be great.
What is your physical therapy, perks?
No, it's, I have to move my arm in different angles. It doesn't seem like it's doing much, but apparently it's good for me.
I'm going to give yourself a nice close-up. All right, let's see. Sharpling has tweeted something. I got to go to the glasses. All right, Sharpling said this. I love Chris Stanley trash-talking me as he descends into full-on bad lieutenant mode.
Hey, I take that as a compliment. Bad Lieutenant's a great movie.
Which one?
Both.
You got to pick.
Two.
Wait a minute. I wanted you to just see that camera angle. As you wipe your nose, the camera just does this huge, crazy sweep.
I got one arm, and the sweat is just pouring down my nose.
Now, let me also say this.
Yeah.
Fuck you for going against Harvey Keitel. No New Yorker in the history of the world would pick something over Harvey Keitel.
I love Harvey Keitel, but I love Nicolas Cage, too, and I just, the second one is just so good.
It makes no sense.
It doesn't make sense.
The first one, what are you doing sweating like that?
I don't know, man.
Why don't you sit down?
Is it because you're scoping?
It's for the Percocets.
Right, by the way, we're doing the Bennington Family Thanksgiving at the Hard Rock. We're overwhelmed with requests. I don't know what we're going to do about it. It's just at least 4 or 5 times bigger than what we can even do.
Right.
So you said full lottery mode for this?
Yeah, this is full lottery mode. If you want to jump into the lottery.
I just want to see how far me and Gail look away from this.
Hey, guys, how's it going?
Yeah.
It's, you can email benningtongigs@gmail.com. That's happening November 18th at the Hard Rock Cafe at 7 p.m. Email benningtongigs@gmail.com for a chance to win free tickets.
And I'm a little nervous about this because people are offering Chris all kinds of tchotchkes. I might have to take it away from Chris being the one who decides.
Oh, I can't be bribed, Ron.
Yes, you can.
With 3 Marlboro Reds and a Valium, you give up your home.
But yeah, BenningtonGigs@gmail.com.
Full Bad Lieutenant mode. New Orleans style. To the break of dawn, baby.
Where's the kibble? Give me that kibble.
Of course, you know the jerk off scene, don't you? You got that on a fucking vine at your house.
Ejected on the side of the
room.
No
shit! Oh, come on! Come on!
Yeah. Well, I guess this is going to turn into a roast battle. As everything does. Let's see. This is fucking funny from Queen Elizabeth. She said, I had a C-section and took a Tylenol afterwards. Hicks is a pussy.
Hey, guess what? All right, I had 7 anchors put into my shoulder, whatever that means. And
what do we have to deal with now? We have to and talk to this person. Fucking <head. laughs> You look fucking crazy. Like, from our angle, you look like a crazy person.
From this angle, we all look great. So, I mean, I think that's and on Periscope. So, you know, that's what's... It says STL.
Now I'm just staring at the back of your sweaty neck.
It's so soaked in fucking water.
You know what? This is what... It's good. This is going to be the tape they show on CNN when they do the story. Did a shock jock show make their insane... He laughed as he sweat.
No, I'm good. I'm not going to OD. I'm good.
Finally.
STL. STL, Scope Talk Live. Scope Bros. Share the broadcast, Scope Bros.
All right. Learn down the hall said, what's up? Got my costume on for the SXM Halloween party. Come on down, Lauren. We'd love to see you. Let me guess what you're dressed as this year. Lolita?
Love of my life.
She's wanted to be on Smoking with Chris for a while, and you haven't had her on there.
She, you have to smoke if you're on Smoking with Chris. So,
well, how hard is that to smoke?
Yeah. Okay. Some people won't smoke. And they're like, no, I can't do it.
Who'd you try to get on? Nancy Reagan?
I tried to get. I think I tried to get Mark Zito on, and he says he doesn't smoke. I was like, all right, fine, fuck you.
Well, just give him some of that nicotine gum.
That should count.
Yeah.
All right. Here's some chew. Here's some Skull.
That'd you should cool. always have a blue on you, too, because that's not hard to smoke.
I was thinking about trying to get some vapors on, but it's not a cigarette.
Like David Tell said, I'm smoking science. You had a problem with this? I'm smoking science. So, Smoke Talk... Or Spoke... Wait a minute. What is the name of this?
Scope Talk Live.
Scope Talk. There's so many shows now.
Hell yeah.
I thought it was Smoke Talk Live. Named after... Smoking with Chris episodes. That
I have
all
good talk scope live after.
Alright, oh, Sexy Devil is here.
Nice.
Sexy
Look,
Devil.
It's Sexy Devil.
Oh my god,
it's
it is not.
Yes, it is.
No, it is.
You
it.
Are a foxy devil. She am I on Periscope? Am I on the scope?
Yeah, you
Hi.
Are.
Hi. Hi, everybody.
Hi, welcome to Scope Talk Live. Lauren, thanks for being on the panel.
No worries.
Now,
I don't think I could put this on over my ears.
Yeah, you don't have to. They're not ears, they're horns.
Sorry.
Now, why are you dressed like the sexy devil?
It's just ears. It's just and red lipstick, too. I sent it. See? Periscope.
You know, let me just say this. You see, this is what has kept Cousin Brucey alive.
Oh.
You know what I mean? This keeps his head beating. Because she has come in like the fourth wife and just taken over his life. I can't even get close to him anymore in the halls.
Oh, God, no.
Yeah.
She's giving some.
I think it has to go through Lauren. So, Lauren is our friend, Lauren down the hall, Staten Island girl.
Yes.
Really like the movie Working Girl. I thought this might be fun. You could dance up there in your sexy devil thing to Stanglehold. It's the new theme of Opie's show. I can't get back on the show anymore.
Because of the Stangles.
Yeah, I've been Stangleholded.
Yeah.
You know? And the last time I went on, I heard a lot of good, positive feedback.
Yeah, you know? You did. That's right. People loved it.
So give us a little Stanglehold to play that, and the sexy devil can just give us a slight dance.
I can dance in my seat to it.
Yeah, well, okay, that's perfect.
Oh, wait, it's not a song?
It is a song. He's too stupid to realize he can hit play.
Stanglehold! The song, Joe! You're making STL look bad.
I like that he tried to do both, getting the song and still.
I hear you can dance along to this. Give it
give
some
us the volume.
And the volume in the room too, Chris. She's a good dancer.
She is. She's gonna feel the rhythm a little bit. Okay. Get free.
It is a sexy devil.
Here I come again now.
Baby! Oh my god.
Got you in
think we can do any better than that. You know what I mean? Now we got Hot Dancing Girls. Yeah.
We peaked. That's it.
But yeah, I want to get her and Danny on together for a contest.
Yes, I would love to do that. Game show.
Game show, king of the oldies, king or queen of the oldies.
Okay, yeah. I think that'd be fair.
Now, what time is the big SiriusXM social today?
It's actually going on right now.
Well, I heard it was, the pizza party?
Yeah.
Who's our interns today?
Both Cashmere and Jamban.
All right, let those guys know that they are in charge of getting pizza for this show. They can't head on down there. Who's got the big funny content, costume?
There was, actually not a lot of people are dressed up. There was one guy dressed like Indiana Jones upstairs, and that was it.
That was it, good.
That was it.
Just I like the fact we're adults here.
I try to get in the spirit, I try.
Yeah, because it's madness with the TV shows. Every TV show is ridiculous.
Yeah, everything. In New York.
Yeah. You know what? We could send. Well, we'll send Dan down to. No, we better not send him down to Scope there. Somebody might get their feelings hurt. You know what I mean? I was going to send him down to do the contest, but Dan has a way of pushing the envelope.
Well, and you know his edgy comedy.
Hey, Dan, when is your web series going to be? Do you know? Do you know when you start shooting that?
Oh, we started shooting already, actually. Yeah, and so we shot the first episode, and we're going to shoot the next five. Within the next two or three weeks, we're going to start.
I saw a trailer for another web series that you were in.
Oh, is it the Mike Brown one?
Yes.
Yes, that episode actually dropped. That's on YouTube.
What's the name of that?
Where can you find it?
It's I know the title of the web series is Can't Stop, Won't Stop. And I'm a white guy who they bait into saying the N-word a lot.
But did they bleep it?
I did very well.
Well, you're a natural. But did they bleep it in the trailer?
They did, yeah.
It's the internet already. They wrote the bit. They produce it, then they bleep themselves.
Not only that, Mike, who's a very funny comic, wrote the script and is encouraging me to say it. He's like, all right, just say it. So the first take we do it, I say it, and then he's like, whoa, cut, whoa, you said it with the ER. And I'm like, you wrote that. He's like, you are, man.
Mike Brown did that?
Yeah,
there's an interview with him tomorrow on the iBang and talking about this. And we can't stop. And we
won't stop.
Nice, Chris.
Won't stop.
But you didn't do a close-up of yourself.
Okay, hold.
That seems to be the big problem that people have with the Roman Polanski of Periscope, is that when... his camera work, that he puts an extreme close-up on himself when he talks.
And we won't stop.
Like, right on the mouth.
Yeah.
Well, make sure they know where the sound's coming from.
By the way, there is an organization that wants to sponsor Smoking with Chris. I think it would be the first Periscope sponsor. They're called Buttered Rolls of New Jersey. And they just try to push the fact that, why not have a buttered roll?
You know what? You're going to make buttered rolls cool again. And that's what I love.
Wait, they weren't cool for a time?
Not with non-alcohol. All right, look who came through for his jam band. An entire pizza.
Whoa. Woo!
This is the best Halloween ever.
Now, is this Uncle Paul's pizza?
No, it is not. It's not Uncle Paul's.
That's insane.
It's from Boca.
All the way from Florida?
Wow.
Oh, nice. Boker. Boker, as the Long Island Jews call it. We're going to Boca this weekend. It's lovely. We've got a condominiums.
Have you been to Boca?
Boca's amazing! It's honestly like Long Island of the South.
You gotta see my condo in Boca.
Boker. Got you in a stanglehold, baby. I don't know why I can't get back on that show. Oh, Stanglehold.
That was the first time I heard that.
Stanglehold? Yeah. I just invented it today when I was doing a Newscope show called Pissing with Denny. trying to explain why it's so difficult for me to get on Opie's show. All right, people are ready more stuff.
Good.
Now, by the way, this is from Gina. Gail Ann loved you on The Best Show for Life, and thanks for introducing us to Bennington Show and hashtag Smoking with Chris. You're all hilarious. So here's Gail going out. growing satellite as it is by getting new subscribers.
Look at that. Yeah. Isn't that a beautiful thing?
Yeah.
And growing Smoking with Chris.
And you're trying to crush that by ruining my relationship with Tom Sharpling.
That's a gigantic mistake, dude.
Your feud with him.
Sharpling started it. Sharpling's the one who gave me all the shit. And then I had to let him know that people love my camera work.
You're so worried about Scope Bros. I'm worried about Real Bros.
Wow, that's okay? Fucking great, dude.
Look, the Real Bros will always... They're my bros. This is just something new. The Scope Bros.
Hold on.
You want to be a Scope Bro, Sharon, Periscope.
Look, I'll still keep my Real Bros as I grow my Scope Bros. Scope Bros is something that Chris says if you give him a share. You know what a Scope Bro is? Luis J. Gomez alerted the iBang the other night that Shtick or Treat was going on in Brooklyn. 50 unknown comics or lesser known comics do impressions of classic comics.
Okay.
And then the guy who did Patrice O'Neill was amazing.
Yeah?
Amazing. Yeah. It was kind of a fun... Mark Norman was the only one that I recognized that was on the show.
Well, you didn't know that some of the other comics...
I'm sure Dan does. Dan, What's that?
He knows all the comics.
Well, he knows the comics that play rooms that don't exist.
Pop-up.
Yeah, they are pop-up. It's like a ninth floor of a Chinatown, and it's in an apartment, and Dan's middling there. Do you know about this Shtick or Treat?
Yeah, it's a great show. They do that every year. Mark Norman hosted, actually, so it's his annual show at Knitting Factory in Brooklyn. That's where Hannibal used to run his weekly show there. And the guy who did Patrice was Clark Jones, who's a super funny comic out of Chicago.
He did an unbelievable... So you were watching, or you were there that night?
I had to get there not until after the show was over, but I saw a video of Clark, and there were some other really good ones also.
It was one of 18 shows that Dan did that night. We ought to do a jump around with Dan, except for nobody wants to spend that much on the subway.
I know.
I'm gonna lose connection. But on Saturday, I'm going to be doing a couple things, two things at the Creek. One of them is kind of like Shtick or Treat, so I can Periscope that, and then just a regular stand-up show after that.
Shtick or Treat ripoff?
It's a Shtick or Treat ripoff, yeah. It's even lesser, some even lesser known.
Doing even more lesser known. Yeah.
Star-studded for you.
Well, we're gonna do something with Dan at the Bennington show. He's actually producing a segment for us with stand-up. We're not, not really ready to announce that right now.
No spoilers. But
you have something you wanted to bring up, right?
Yes, I just saw a tweet from Brad Steiner at Brad Stinks.
Okay.
When Gail Ann and the iBang talk about intern Alex and his hot new Scope show, Ode to Chris Stanley, equals greatest day of my career.
Well, Brad Stinks, yeah.
Yeah, for us too, really. Yeah, I mean, we're just excited to know about intern Alex.
Yeah.
Hey, Brad Stinks, Alex Stinks. How about that, dude? All right, because you're fucking running some crazy Scope Bro ripoff campaign when I'm the original Scope Bro guy.
It's a Shtick or Treat, really, if you think about it. Yeah.
Scope or Treat.
Yeah. This is the one night that Dan gets to steal material. Without everyone yelling at him. What comedian are you going to do?
Well, the other day I did a Bernie Mac's Def Jam set verbatim.
Okay, and what are you going to do this week?
On Saturday, I'm going to do this guy who you don't know, this Asian dude who I think would be great on Thanksgiving with very long hair who, I don't know, he was like born under the Manhattan Bridge. He's a very weird guy. His name is Phil Philly.
Well, while you're making fun of it, there's actually a hospital there. So it's a fine place.
Was he in
a
hospital?
Nah, he should be, though.
All right, let me hear just a little bit of your Bernie Mac, then.
I ain't scared of you motherfuckers. All right, I'm going to tell you something straight off the motherfucking press. I had to come up with no foolishness. In New York, goddamn it, y'all motherfucking women look good. Like a bacon egg sandwich look good. Love sex. Can't do shit no more. And I'm blessed. I'm big boned. I'm heavy structure. I'm hung low.
Let me tell you how pissed I am that he does that really well. Really, really let down. Because here's the thing, I am like Bernie Mac. I love that guy.
That just made me want to watch that.
Yeah.
It's the funniest. I think it's the funniest TV stand-up set ever.
Yeah, I know. I do feel like going back and watching it now, too. But everything that he ever did, like even a terrible movie like Mr. 3000, I never turned it off.
Oh, yeah. Because the delivery is out of control.
Amazing. Amazing.
Just every word he says just oozes funny. Like later in that set, he's like, women doing their thing talk to you the way they want to talk to somebody. It don't make no more fucking sense. It's the funniest thing.
It's amazing. So when you were a kid, you memorized that on your own?
I would replay that like it was a song. Just over, like in the shower, just playing that shit.
No, you didn't do blackface, did you? That would be fucking wrong.
No.
I mean, just, what's your problem with that?
You know, it'd be more authentic.
You're seriously perked up, fucking beast. I wouldn't even let you sleep with this underage devil. You got a boyfriend in your life yet?
I don't.
This is on purpose.
No, right? It's not. Doing I don't. It on purpose.
I mean, you haven't had a boyfriend since I met
no,
you.
No, I know. I don't date a lot, honestly. I don't. I'm always here. Gail sees me all the time in the halls. Am I not here at any day part? I am here.
Then you're dating someone that you shouldn't be dating, and it's a secret.
Maybe what you need is an office romance.
She's got one. I don't know, Rob Cross?
It's Rides Cross.
Let's go,
Rob. RC in the house.
I thought that you were acting like she was the lucky dog because she got some of that cross buns.
Got some of that crossfire.
Hot cross buns. Crossfire, baby. Yeah.
Crossfire.
No, not Rob.
Who is it then? Somebody.
Nobody.
You're not allowed
to
say.
There's also policies intact that you can't date.
I know, but I started a rumor long ago because I thought it was true that you were with Anthony.
I know. That yeah. always comes up every time I'm in here. Can never avoid it.
It just seems like it's so right.
We like a lot of the same things. That's where it ends.
Okay. Right. Well, you like things, and he pretends he likes things.
No. So he gets me too.
Yeah.
I like that too so much.
I've got one in the basement of my mansion. You can see it now. That thing looks like a Kids R Us down there. You know, there was, when I was watching the other night of the Shtick or Treat, there was one woman in the Periscope that, you know, you write stuff in, that was furious whenever anyone would do a dead comic. Like, somehow that crossed the line.
Really?
Yeah, I think it was John Panette that she was just fucking freaking out about.
How dare you,
yeah.
sir?
And the Patrice thing, I felt like it was so great just to, you know, hear that material, somebody doing that material and doing it right. And Panette was, Jesus Christ, was he a funny son of a bitch. I don't know, I'm starting to think we got better dead comics than we have live comics.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
All the laughter in heaven.
Thank God for those hologram tours.
I can't wait to get a Bernie Mac hologram tour going. Yeah, I'm going to watch it in 3D. Anthony and Lauren invite me over in front of his big screen.
I'm going to stand right in the projection of the hologram. I'm him.
I'm that person. I guess we're done. Scope talking. I mean, is there anything else to get into, Chris?
I think we've had a well-rounded STL for this show. Really?
Way, speaking of STL, I heard you talking about your chlamydia that you got
in college. Yeah,
big deal.
It was the big deal. We could antibiotics. Everything was great.
Antibiotics.
What's it?
No, it's not a big deal for men to get it. This is what we were talking about before.
Yeah.
Women, it could be dangerous.
Is chlamydia the one where they put the swab in your pee hole?
Yeah. They took a Q-tip, fucked my dick with it.
Yeah. Well, you know what? I do that anyway, so it would be fine with me.
What?
Little dabble, do you? I like
it. Hurts too much.
I bet it would feel good, just like when you do it in your ears.
No! Oh. No! No! No!
Eargasm.
No.
I love that feeling.
Yeah, when you hit that one spot, it just goes down your spine.
No, not when they're looking for the chlamydia. Just hurts. Just
you know, that's how they used to, in the old West days, they used to fix VD by taking a hot wire on a man, right?
No.
And then shoving it in up his pistols. Kind of sear that area. And I'm like, why did they ever stop? It seems like it worked.
No! Antibiotics! That's what works.
Why is the emphasis on Biden?
I thought that's how everyone said it.
Erwin.
Everybody says antibiotics.
Everybody clugging tipsy.
Love that song.
Yeah. By the way, when you go on Periscope and you're going around the world, China, South America, Russia, it's hard to believe how big Drake is. They are playing him everywhere.
I love Drake.
Yeah. He's like, come on, your cell phone. They're like, why is this song so gigantic?
What's that other good one that we love so much, Chris?
It's like, I don't love it, but the song is, we were at the bottom, now
started
we're here.
Started at the bottom, now we're here. Started at the bottom, now the whole team here. Why don't you like that?
Because he didn't start at the bottom. He started on fucking Degrassi, The Next Generation. He's a rich kid actor.
Canadian TV?
Yeah.
Everyone loved that show.
You can't get any lower than Canadian TV.
It's not the bottom. Yeah.
Started at the bottom, now we're here. Started at the bottom, now the whole team here. That's good.
You want to go, Dan's doing a salute to black people. And you should go do that with him.
You can come out to that song.
You can come out, period. You can finally come out.
It's safe here.
Admit it on STL. Admit it.
Do it. You won't do it.
Fine. Whatever.
Started at the bottom.
That's good.
Now, by the way, Chris, you were talking about you're buying new shirts, right? Because you have to have button shirts?
Yeah, I have to now wear all my shirts need to be buttoned while my arm's in the sling.
But we've seen you on those stupid plaid things for how long? You've got button shirts.
I have I have like four. Yeah. And I don't want to do like laundry. So I went on jcpenney.com and got some nice button-down shirts, $14.99 on sale. They came in yesterday. This is one of them. Check it out, Scope Bros.
It's very shiny.
Is it?
Yeah, it's got a nice sheen to it.
That's the sweat.
that's called Kurt's sweat.
It's just pouring off me.
Thing about Chris, look at him. He's taken off now with his new show. I guess you could say he started at the bottom.
Now he's here.
Started at the bottom, now I'm here.
Yeah, come on, Chris.
Started at the bottom, now the whole team here. Bottom that way, here. Started at the bottom, now the whole team scoping.
Oh, Jesus.
What up, Scope Bro?
He tried to parry it.
Scope Bros, share.
Actually, is there any reason why we just don't do this throughout the whole show anyway?
Yeah, we could do this. My phone's about to die. I need a charger.
Well, we're gonna close it down.
Oh, okay.
We're gonna close this son of a bitch down. Yeah, we will take a break and come back and start the show. Maybe even from the beginning, do the song. All
yeah, why
over.
Not? Same song?
Yeah, we'll keep rockabilly. Is there a rockabilly that you'd like to hear?
Yeah, let's pick a different one.
I'm wondering if you and Lauren, because Lauren likes the early hits.
I do.
As well.
Do you have a favorite rockabilly song? We did some Wanda Jackson this week. We did Buddy Holly.
I love Buddy Holly.
She's so stumped. Well, we already did Buddy Holly this week.
Well, the killer. How about we come back with the killer?